In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create subtitles with a fixed position on just one text layer using a very simple expression. Stick around, you don't want to miss this episode. Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This tutorial will help you develop skills using hold keyframes, the value expression, and the text source property. You'll learn skills and techniques that you can use every day at your job, for your clients, and in your own personal projects. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at Envato Elements. Check them out today using the link in the description below and get an amazing 70% off your first month, as well as unlimited downloads with your membership. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Envato Elements has everything a serious motion graphic designer could possibly want or need. Once you sign up, you won't remember how you ever animated before Envato Elements. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, to the amazing 70% discount from Envato Elements, and the project files are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Right-click in this area that's to the left of our timeline, New, Shape Layer, and then let's open that up, and we're going to add in a rectangle, and then let's give that a fill. Let's open up our Fill and Rectangle settings. Let's change this color from red to black. Shape layer paths are always measured in pixels, not percentages. So this is a 1920 by 1080 comp, so we can make our X value on size 1920, so that way it spans the width of our comp. I'm going to make our height about 175. Let's bring down our opacity to about 50%. Change our Y value on this shape layer to 960. So our text is going to be right in here, but I want it to stay there at all times. And that's really what the point of this tutorial is. I have an audio file that I want to bring in. I just want to use this mainly as a guide to show you how subtitling can work. So let's just drag that in. Hit O to go to the end of this layer. Hit N to bring our handle to the right of it. And then just right click, trim comp to work area. So that way we're just going to be working within this area right here. Now with the audio layer selected, hit LL to bring up our audio waves. So this is a good guide that we can go by to know when we need to change our subtitles from one sentence to the next. Let's just listen to a few seconds of this. This is where captions are located. You can add more text as you go using only one line of text. Okay, so I already have this text typed out, so I'm going to show you how we can add in these subtitles. First, Control T to bring up our text tool, and then I'm going to grab this first sentence from my document and just double click and then paste that. Highlight this, and let's just change this font to, we'll just do like an Arial regular, just something kind of basic. And then I want to right click, transform, center anchor point and layer content, P for position, and we're going to go 960. So that way we're on top of this shape layer right here. So let's go back to the very beginning of this layer. And now let's Option or Alt click on position and just type value, comma, open bracket, 960, comma, 960. We have a closed bracket that should finish that expression off. Notice now I can't move my position at all using my position setting for the layer because we've set our value to equal this at all times. Where the trick comes in is what we do when we want to change our text to the next sentence. Open up this layer and we want to put a keyframe on source text. And notice it comes in as a hold keyframe. We also want to put a keyframe on our anchor point. Make sure you right click because it comes in as a linear keyframe. And then just toggle this to a hold keyframe. Now let's select a layer, hit U, so all we see are our hold keyframes. As we can see with the wave file, this is our first sentence here. I'm going to just copy my next sentence that I want to include. Now if we double click on our text layer, so it highlights it, and I'm just going to paste this next line. See how this wrapped around to the next line? You want to make sure this is all on one line here. So now the key to making this work so that way it stays in the same spot every time. There are a few ways you can do this. One way is you can right click on this layer, go to transform, and then choose center anchor point and layer content. And this will put your anchor point in the middle of this layer. If you're on PC, you can choose Control Alt Home, and that will center your anchor point in your text layer. If you're on a Mac, just use Command Option plus Home, and it does the same thing. So now both of these are centered right here at 960 by 960. There are also third-party plugins that you can use. I have a few that I use from time to time. This first one is Motion Tools by School of Motion. You can move your anchor point anywhere you want using these options here. So we always want to make sure we hit our center right here. Now, in order to get this, you have to go to School of Motion, I believe, and sign up for a course. This one right here is from animation composer, Mr. Horse, you may know it as. And you have this anchor point mover, and it basically does the same thing. Now, there are some differences in how these two plugins work. I'm not really going to get into that right now. The main thing to know is that for purposes of this tutorial, you can use one of these anchor point movers right here, and it makes life a lot easier. And the one for animation composer is absolutely free. If we watch this playback, we'll see how our text changes when it gets to this second line. This is where captions are located. You can add more text as you go. I want to grab my next line. And as you can see, these are my notes for this episode. So I'm just going to copy this layer here, go to our text layer, double click, and add that. And now we see again that this is wrapped around, so let's just backspace. So look, if we push in right here, we can see that our anchor point isn't completely centered. It's really close, but it's not dead center. Now, if we right click, choose transform and center anchor point, watch, and it will slightly move just to adjust. So did you see that slight movement? I'm going to undo that. So you can see that it did in fact move. Transform, center anchor point, and layer content. I'm going to hit EE for our expression. So what this expression is doing is it's telling our position to always be at 960, 960. What makes it move is whenever we change our anchor point, it forces this text to conform to the position that we've included in this expression. Like this line right here, we're going to put on two different lines of text, and this will give you a better idea of how this expression is working. We double click, we paste that, and I just put this in here to notate to myself. This needs to go to the second line. So see, now that we have this here, we can see that our text isn't centered within this shape layer. Again, if you just right click, transform, center anchor point and layer content, and it snaps right to the same position. So see, we can kind of scrub through here and see that our subtitles are always going to be at 960, 960, as long as our anchor point has been centered and it's always on one text layer. So you then center your anchor point, and this is a good one to use. Let me see. So right here, if we double click on our text layer and hit paste, we can see again that it's not centered. All you'd have to do is right click, transform, center anchor point and layer content. And I'm going to back out of that just to show you how these third-party plugins work. So we're right here. Now if we go to our anchor point mover from Mr. Horse, just click the center and it pops right in. Same thing from Motion Tools, just click the center and it pops right in. If we change this expression, so instead of 960, 960, we can change it to 960, 800. See, our text moves up, and I'm just going to go ahead and move this also to 960, 800. As we go through our keyframes, we can see that all of the text has now moved up to this 960, 800. And they are consistent because our anchor point was centered at each point along the way. What if I want to change this font? So just click on this and maybe I'll do like Gotham bold, for example. But if you notice, when we get before this hold keyframe, our text is still that Arial. That's because our source text is changing at each keyframe. And the source text keyframe includes all the information for that text layer, including your character, whether or not it's bold, the size of it, the kerning, the leading, and everything. If you want to change all of your text to be the same font and you don't like Arial, all you have to do is simply click on source text, and notice it highlights all of these keyframes. And then we can change this, we'll say Gotham Regular, for example. And now if you notice, it's all changed to Gotham Regular. If you want to change the size or the font, it's going to change your text only at the keyframe unless you click on source text and you highlight all of these keyframes. And now this is something to keep in mind also. What if I misspelled a word? I need to fix this right here. If you just fix this word randomly on your timeline, you'll notice it puts in another keyframe here. The main thing is make sure whenever you make changes, you're at the actual keyframe. Otherwise, you could run into some issues. And see, since we changed our font, we need to make sure that all of our anchor points are correct. So right click, center anchor point, and layer content. And see how it's a little bit off. Just go to the next keyframe here, and let's use one of our third-party plugins. I'm going to use School of Motion, so I can just hit the center anchor point option on all of these. Since fonts are shaped differently, if you do change your font, you may need to go back and then correct your anchor point setting like that. This kind of slightly moved up, it looks like, right there. If we zoom in, see that my keyframe was slightly off. When you make changes, make sure you're on the keyframe because it's easy to miss. You can save this as an animation preset. Let's close up this layer, then type P for position. Select position so you grab the expression. Now go to Animation, Save Animation Preset. Save this to your documents, Adobe, the version you're using, and user presets. I'm going to drop mine in the 7-minute AE folder, and I'm going to call it Fixed Position. Click Save. Now, if we go back to our Effects and Presets panel, we see that it's right there. Just select any text layer and double-click this preset, and it will be added to that layer. So remember, if you're creating subtitles and you want to have them in a specific location, you can type this expression, value, comma, open bracket, 960, comma, whatever value you want, close bracket. Add a keyframe for your source text, which will always default to a hold keyframe. And then put a keyframe on your anchor point settings, but make sure you toggle that to a hold keyframe. And you want to make all of your changes at the keyframe. But if you need to make changes such as font, size, color, anything else like that, and you want to be consistent across the board, click on source text in order to highlight all of those keyframes and make your changes at that point. And center your anchor point at each keyframe. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, the amazing 70% discount from Envato Elements, and the project file for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.